Hi viewers, okay, if you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you'll get notifications further. And if you like my video, please like it and share it. Okay, so now we'll discuss about cyclic photophosphorylation. In the previous session, we have been discussed about non-cyclic photophosphorylation, how the synthesis of ATP as well as NADPH2 takes place. Okay, and this is cyclic photophosphorylation, which can be seen in bacteria as well as when there is failure of non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So cyclic photophosphorylation, it occurs in prokaryotes as well as when there is failure of non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Okay, so if there is failure of non-cyclic photophosphorylation, then there is chance of cyclic photophosphorylation in all the green plants. Okay, and this usually occurs in prokaryotes, that is bacteria, and in plant cells. If there is failure of non-cyclic photophosphorylation, then it leads to cyclic photophosphorylation. Okay, so here cyclic, the name itself says cyclic flow of electrons takes place in cyclic photophosphorylation, and photophosphorylation is synthesis of ATP from ADP and inorganic phosphate during the cyclic transportation of these electrons. Okay, now let's see. So cyclic photophosphorylation is involved with only photosystem 1. Okay, only photosystem 1 is involved in cyclic photophosphorylation. There is no involvement of two photosystems here. Only one photosystem is involved, that is photosystem 1, where the chlorophyll molecules, that is pigment molecules, which absorbs, which are present in the photosystem, which absorbs light at wavelength of 700 nanometers or more than 680 nanometers. So this absorbs light at 700 nanometers, so this absorbs sunlight at 700 nanometers or even greater than 680 nanometers. Okay, so once it is absorbing sunlight, so this will be energized and this will not be in a stable ground state. It gets excited, it gets excited and releases the electrons. So from photosystem 1, once the electrons are being released, this will be going in uphill manner, which will be accepted by primary electron acceptor. So this is primary electron acceptor. So what is primary electron acceptor of photosystem 1? That is ferredoxin. Ferredoxin is a primary electron acceptor, of electrons. So from ferredoxin, is iron sulfur containing protein, and from ferredoxin the electrons will be passing through plastoquinone. So while the electrons are passing downhill process, it releases some amount of energy. So when it is, when the electrons are passing down the gradient, so down process, it releases some amount of energy. That energy is trapped by ADP and inorganic phosphate to synthesize ATP. So now it is phosphorylation in the presence of light. So it is photophosphorylation. And next, the electrons will be further passed from plastoquinone to cytochrome complex. So cytochrome complex means, as we have been discussed in the previous session, that is cytochrome B6 as well as cytochrome F. So when these electrons are passing through cytochrome complex, which are iron containing protein, and there is synthesis of again one more ATP. So when the electrons are passing downhill way, the energy which is being released will be accepted by ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, and inorganic phosphate to synthesize ATP. Okay, again there is ATP synthesis in the presence of light. Okay, and now from plastocyanin, the electrons will be passed to the same chlorophyll molecule. Okay, so the electrons which are being released from the same photosystem will be flowing in a cyclic manner and returned from plastocyanin to the same reaction center. Okay, so now as the electrons are flowing in cyclic manner, okay, so these electrons are flowing in a cyclic manner, okay, that is why we call this as cyclic, and photophosphorylation, that is synthesis of ATP, takes place. So it is cyclic photophosphorylation, and this cyclic photophosphorylation occurs in stroma region or intergranular thylakoids. Okay, so cyclic photophosphorylation occurs in stromal region as well as intergranular thylakoids. So the flow of electrons takes place in a cyclic manner. So from as the electrons are coming from this reaction center, they are returned back to the same reaction center. Okay, so to the same chlorophyll molecules, the electrons will be reverted back. So that is why we call this as cyclic photophosphorylation. And in cyclic photophosphorylation, only ATP synthesis can be seen. Okay, and no NAD PH2 synthesis. Okay, there is no reduction of NADPH2, so only ATP is being synthesized. Okay, only ATP synthesis can be seen, and it is associated with only photosystem 1. There is no involvement of photosystem 2 and no photolysis of water. Okay, there is no photolysis of water. So there is no photolysis of water, okay, as because photosystem 2 is not involved here, only photosystem 1 is involved, and there is no splitting of water molecule. Okay, and it is associated with only photosystem 1. So the primary electron acceptor for photosystem 1 is ferredoxine. Okay, and last electron acceptor, again this plastocyanin will be sending the electrons again back to the same reaction center. So this is about cyclic photophosphorylation. And in the next session, we will see the differences between cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Thank you.